dream. Martin had a dream. Kendrick have a dream. All my life I want money and power. Respect my mind or die from less y'all. I pray my dick get big as the Eiffel Tower, so I can fuck the world for 72 hours. Goddamn, I feel amazing. Damn, I'm in the matrix. My mind is living on cloud nine and this nine is never on vacation. Start up that Maserati and vroom vroom, I'm racing. Popping pills in the lobby and I pray they don't find her naked. And I pray you niggas is hating. Shooters go after Judas. Jesus Christ, if I live life on my knees, ain't no need to do this. Park it in front of looters. Next to that church is chicken. All you pussies is losers. All my niggas is winning. Screaming all my life, I want money and power. Respect my mind.
Welcome back to the Why So Serious podcast. We are back for our Black Lightning recap. Today, we skipped an episode. Too much scheduling shit. So we're just going to go to the next one. We are recapping Black Lightning Season 1, Episode 8. The Book of Revelations. Black Lightning works with Anissa to help find information to clear Black Lightning's name. Jennifer begins interning for Lynn. Meanwhile, Gambi finds himself in a precarious situation. Devin, Danielle, what do you guys think about this latest episode?
Hold on, time out. What did I miss? Are we doing 2-for-1 today? We gonna give them 2-for-1? Let's do it.
That's a lot.
What shit? Let's give it to them. Let's go 7 and 8. Let's do it. Look, I'm tired. I'm laying in my bed, but I'm trying to get the people what they want, and they want 2 episodes.
Oh my God! It's behind. All right. 7 is Equinox, the Book of Fate. Black Lightning pursuit of Tobias continues, and Anissa continues to find herself in the new normal. So I guess we'll do overall thoughts of 7 and 8.
We doing that shit live. We ain't got no notes. We going live, baby. For y'all, we love you out there, podcast world. We love you.
So, what'd you think? Answer their question.
I mean, shit, I didn't even know Danielle would go. I mean, I like ladies first.
What is wrong with y'all? Okay, first of all, 7 and 8, I think were very dope. They're both action-filled. What I like about 7 is that, okay, now, I know I love my Black woman, and Lady E was my boo, but look, she had it coming.
Oh, my God. Jeez. Yeah. She didn't have to go out like that, though.
She was ruthless, okay? First, you know, we'll talk about it. But then, I like the latest episode, 8, was freaking dope because Jen got her powers. And I think it's dope how she discovered them and everything else. So that's pretty dope. I'm tripped out about the whole Lala, though. That's like
the best interviews in all of goddamn TV land is Lala. He make you want to go back in the 70s. And love somebody and riding the old Cadillac, old school, whatever. Shit, I just love Lala.
I think the last two were definitely dope.
I gotta say that I didn't want Lady Eve to go out like that. I just love her diabolical ass. And then fuck Gambi for life. I'm just team hate colonizers now. Gambi's the fucking worst. And I hope he gets it in the end. And I don't care if I just need him to make Jenna's suit and finish up on Anissa's suit. Anissa, I'm sorry. Happy Lala back. Lady Eve took a lot of people with her. I love that shit. And yo, my man Lala out here talking to ghosts and shit. That shit is dope. We got a lot of good shit to get into. And it's always Mr. Clark. Say it's Freeland, and I'm just here for it, yo. We're just always here for it.
All right. Yeah, I enjoyed both episodes. I liked 8 better than 7, but I definitely enjoyed both of them. And I really am intrigued with what's going on with Mr. Esposito, Gambi's real name. He's trying to hide his heritage. But we know you're Hispanic. All right? We know you're a brown person, so... You don't got to hide from us no more, buddy. So I really enjoyed that and figuring that out. Trying to figure out what the fuck's going on with him because I still don't know what's going on with him. And I was good. It was good to see fucking racist ass Hollis Doyale from Scandal.
Yeah.
In episode 8. So he plays a great racist and a great asshole. So I'm glad to see he's going to be in the next few episodes.
First of all, he didn't have to come at us like that. Talk about some... give them some green light because they ain't good for nothing. I said, oh, wait a minute. No, we cannot do that. I almost turned up on that TV. But yeah, we'll get to that. But yeah, that part kind of got me a little mad, but I'm good.
So I'm going to, because it'll take too long to go through every scene of both. So I'm going to skip around 7 and then we'll do our regular thing for 8. So on 7, what did you guys think when you saw Tobias fighting that fucking drugged up dude in the cage?
Oh. Son, I didn't know he had hands like that. I said, okay, Tobias.
The nigga don't die. What are you talking about? You didn't know he had hands. Hey, he matter.
Look, I didn't know he had hands like that. That was dope how they started the episode off like that with him. And then his punchlines were like the fucking best. He said, give me somebody that's worth my time. I was just like, okay, Tobias.
He was like, that nigga was on some shit because I was supposed to go through him like fucking race through like wet paper. And the motherfucker was like, this nigga was on some shit. And the nigga was juicing. He was on that green light. But yeah, man, this shit was crazy just to see, like, you gotta be like, Tobias can't die anyway because they brought the nigga back. And I really, really just want to know how they bringing these motherfuckers back to life now. Because I feel like now Lady Eve got to come back.
But look, yeah. Tobias was like, he don't fuck with green light because he sell it to these niggas and they die. So he don't get no more money.
Right. Oh, yeah, true. He was definitely on some shit, though. That shit was good, though. That's a smart drug dealer, though.
I guess he's a smart drug dealer, but I
don't know. Don't make your product too good, because if the niggas dying off the shit, you gonna have customers no more. Yeah. Their customers ain't paying.
So that's what got him to beef. He was already mad at Lady Eve because of that. And because
he was mad about that dust shit.
Yeah, because of the albino dust. But that kind of made him mad too. So then we also, it was the episode after Anissa found out that her dad was Black Lightning. So of course she's like, nigga, you been fucking telling me all this MLK bullshit and you out here electrocuting people this whole time. And I'm like, you're not wrong. But now, then she immediately switched into like hype mode. Like, all right, so we're gonna get out here. We're gonna be tag teaming.
Hell yeah!
When I'm getting my
suit, she turned that to a weed real quick, didn't she?
So I don't know why he had to come at her like that. But I am on her side. But she got relaxed. Like, we'll see more of it in 8. But she a little too aggressive with this shit.
She is who she is. The whole since we've been introduced to who the fucking Anissa is going in. But she goes in head first and, like, doesn't even think about the things she does, like, how to even be a hero. She just says, I want to take action and then deal with the consequences later and shit. And it definitely puts a lot of people in danger because she's so strong and doesn't even know the capabilities of her powers yet. So she really needs to learn her powers before she become a real hero.
Yeah, she's way too hype. She experienced that she... is like her dad, so now she's trying to really carry that role, which is, you know, I mean, shoot, if you discovered you had powers, you know, I would be hype as hell too and want to save everybody, but I do think it would be smarter if she perfected her craft first.
She came with her mom real tough, though. She was real talking to Lynn. I ain't really like that shit. Like, you know, I'm still your mother. Like, bitch, like, I know I don't know what it feels like to have power, but you ain't got to come with me like that. Like, you know what I mean? And then she reveals like that pretty much the reason that their parents got divorced is because he was Black Lightning, and I don't think Anissa could respect that. But you know, I get Lynn's whole, you know, process about, you know, saying that I got to step away from Jefferson because like you're putting your family in jeopardy and you're out here hurting yourself. And then I don't want to be in the middle of that, so I'm gonna take our girls. And I don't know why the girls end up living with Jefferson. That's kind of weird to me, but I guess that'll be revealed later.
Because he's Black Lightning.
I guess, but I mean, he taught her how to fight, but I mean, like, I still feel like he's safer.
He's the fucking Jesus of Freeland. So
he's Black Jesus.
They would have been like, what the fuck? They weren't going to rule against him. She's probably like, I'm not even going to fight this. Everybody love you. I'm not even going to fight it. And plus, she's there every day anyway.
But I like how they made Black Lightning had to come out and tell Anissa exactly what Lynn was telling him about his powers. Because that's real right there. He legit told her everything that Lynn was saying, why she didn't want him to do it. He had to turn around and tell Anissa that, and I thought that was deep.
Yeah, And I just love, we get so many good things as far as reputational wise. Like, I have those great black parents. Like, I do have great black parents. And, like, those fundamental things that parents teach you, and the way they care about you, and the way they worry, and they voice those opinions to you, we get to see in this show. And it's refreshing to see representation on the screen like that.
So what's the next point, you think?
So then, Devin, you still here?
Yeah, you got me.
Yeah, so then Gambi pays a visit to Lady Eve, and he's basically like, Tobias is getting out of control. He's even opening a jazz club. He ain't supposed to be, nobody's supposed to know he's still alive and he's still here. And he about to fucking be out in the open like this. Like, you got to rein this dude in. And Lady Eve was like, yeah, you right, but that nigga make money for me, so I ain't really trying to kill him. So Gambi was like, we got to do something because this is about to be a problem. And I'm like, yo, what is Gambi up to? Like, how did, like, what did they used to do together? And so then she was like, all right, this is what we're going to do. We're going to kill Joey Toledo, send him a message. And Gambi was like, all right. And I'm like, yo, he got it like that. I was like, Gambi ain't got it like that. Little did I know what Gambi could do.
Hell no. First of all, you knew Gambi could do a whole bunch of other shit. Like,
I didn't know he could do that. He killed like 15 people.
He did. Yeah. He went in there like Rambo. I said, okay.
This nigga out here wiping security footage and shit off the fucking
city. Listen, that's some nerd shit. That ain't got nothing to do with you out here killing people by yourself, a one-man wrecking crew.
How much did you love the fucking little bandana over his fucking nose and shit? Yo, that shit was... I was dying,
yo. He looked like the Shadow.
Yo, this shit was so crazy to me, yo. And then, yo, that nigga's a cold-blooded killer, though. Like, that's real. Like, you out here just killing niggas in their face. Joey Chidito watched that motherfucker take the life from him, yo. Shit was crazy.
So then... Oh, go ahead, Danielle.
Now, I just like how he, after he killed him, he left a little box of dust on his chest. Honestly, I thought it was a bomb. I didn't know it was gonna be something. I like the way that I pictured it happening. I thought the guy was gonna be laying there smiling, and then he just blow up, and that was just my overthinking. So when I saw that it was just a box of dust, I was just like, okay, they real disrespectful.
And this shit is just so good, man. This show is so good. Like, we get everything we want. We got my man Jefferson fucking busting in, like, after you found out Joey Toledo, they try to blame it on Tobias and shit. And, like, he goes to the club, and then, like, fucking Tobias' sister end up getting shot. Did she die?
Yeah, she died. We'll get to that. So then Anissa, basically, Jefferson finds out that Anissa's got, like, this old research that her daddy and his friend was doing. And he was like, look, you better go talk to him because you barking up the wrong tree. He in danger. And so she go to the fucking news thing, and they like, oh, he died a week ago. I'm like, yo, so you done got somebody killed off of this bullshit? Like, you fucking up. And so, yeah, go ahead.
Huggy Bear, man. My man Huggy Bear was on there two episodes. Did he get two episodes?
He got one episode. No, yeah. He got maybe two. I think she went back to him after he didn't want to talk to him the first time, but I can't remember if that was the same episode. So then basically Joey Toledo's dead, and Jefferson's kind of mad because he's like, that's my only lead to fucking Tobias, like, and you know, Gambi's lying his ass off, like, I don't know anything about this. You need to leave Tobias alone, blah 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 blah. And I'm like, yo, Gambi, like, I'm still not team anti Gambi. However, you are making it very difficult for me to justify your actions right now. I'm gonna need you to make some things more clear. And I think he did in 8, but I think Devin's still a hater. So.
No, you can't be a hater, yo. You can't be a hater if somebody do shit like that, yo. Like, that nigga playing both sides like shit, yo. You can't respect that shit, yo.
Then we get the big scene where basically Tobias talking to his sister, and he's like, I mean, I can't kill Lady Eve, man. I can't do that. They'll come fuck me up. And then she was like, well, there's one way you can do this where you'll be safe. So then you see Tobias's people roll up on Lady Eve's shop with these fucking electric guns, and they're like, oh, he's going to try to fucking frame Black Lightning for this. But Lady Eve was holding her own. She was fucking them up, using her own men as shields and shit.
Them niggas, yo.
And
That made me so excited.
She fucked them all up. And then, though, she ain't know it was another dude hiding in
with the damn president.
Hiding in the damn coffin and got out and electrocuted the fuck out of her.
And yo, she was burnt so bad, though. And then my man, fucking, what's that dude's name? You think Jeff? The fucking, Henderson? Cop, what's the name? Henderson.
Henderson, like, you'd have gone too far now, Black Lightning.
Hell yeah.
I'm like, you really think this nigga did this shit? Like, golly.
That shit was so funny. Like, yo, nigga, I just was, like, out here looking out for you. And then, like, you think I'm going to go kill somebody and shit? Like, yo, we just had a conversation. I was out here shaking Jody Toledo down and shit. And now you telling me I'm gone too far and you just hang up? We won't even have a conversation. Nigga, get out of here, yo.
Why you had to say that Lady E got lit up? Because she did.
Yo, Toasty is a motherfucker, yo.
First of all, she thought she was good until she, they dead hopped presidents. Up caskets.
Nigga hit that dead president's in her ass, popped out that fucking casket, and was laughing at her ass, and just fucking was jolting the fuck out of her, yo. She took a lot of votes, man.
Yeah, she got fucked up. So then, basically, you go to this last scene where fucking, it's like in the bed, and I'm like, is that fucking Lala? And he laying in this fucking bed, and then LaWanda, the woman he killed, pops up and like, do you believe in a resurrection? Same type of shit Tobias was saying. And I'm like, and he pop up, and I'm like, is this a dream? Is this nigga alive? Like, what the fuck is happening here? So that part I didn't understand. They never explained that shit. But what did you guys think when you saw Lala and that he was still alive?
I just need somebody to give me an example of how to bring these motherfuckers back to life. And then I get it. I don't know the significance of LaWanda being the ghost that brought him back. That shit is crazy.
No, LaWanda is just this voice in his head.
I mean, no, but like, you see the tattoo.
You see the tattoo. When she said, do you believe in the resurrection? And all of a sudden, her little face is on his chest. I'm like, dude, I thought you wanted him dead. Like, he killed you, so how you coming back?
And we get that dialogue in episode 8.
I know, I'm just saying, though, at the end of that one, it just didn't make sense to me.
Oh, no, I was all fucked up. But you know what? Lala was back. You know, my man Latavius with the fucking intro music, man. Shit is gold. TV gold.
So that was episode 7. So episode 8 basically starts out with like Black Lightning doing training, and it's kind of like this training montage with Anissa, and then they cut to like these TV shows of these people turning on Black Lightning, and I was like, why did they put all the Black Republicans on TV? Like
that all the Black Republicans. God damn.
All man. Talking right? shit about Black Lightning. Oh, I knew this nigga wasn't no good. He out here electrocuting people. Judge, jury, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, so you found the 6 Black people who don't like Black Lightning, put them on TV?
I'm about to say, because when he came back, they was like, Black Lightning, oh my goodness, all this time, I've been worried about him. Now all of a sudden, y'all fake, because you think he killed Lady E, who didn't give a damn about y'all anyway. I was so mad.
Yeah, but we find out that Evelyn, Lady Evelyn, is like this pillar of the community. She like Big
Mariah. But you knew she was. You knew she was. We knew she was something special, because remember the first episode, like, you need to go talk to Miss Evelyn, whatever, Lady Eve, whatever. They called her by her name in the first episode, and Jefferson was not trying to have that happen.
But on the low, she ain't care about them people.
No shit.
Do you think Lady Eve knew that Jefferson was Black Lightning?
Hell no. Nah. Because Gambi did a damn good job protecting that boy.
Well, when they said that, I thought I told you to leave the Jefferson family alone. Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I feel like she might have had an idea. I really do. I just feel like because that family was off limits, that...
Because that's who Gambi raised it, like his son. That's why. But, like, I mean, you still don't know that's Black Lightning, though. You know what I mean? Like, they just know that, you know, his father was the columnist, and then Gambi protected him. So he definitely told, and they were in the same organization. So he definitely said, since this tragedy happened to this boy, you that dude is off, he's off limits because I raised him like my son. Like, so you don't really know that he's Black Lightning in that regard.
True.
So then in that training montage, she's telling him, like, all right, you hit this person. And then Anissa fucks up the dude with the Confederate flag shirt. And I'm like, I don't see anything wrong with this, Jefferson. I don't know why you're so upset. Like, he's walking around with a Confederate flag on his shirt.
We get it. Why are you Brandon.
Why are you angry? What?
She was like, walk past me one more time, nigga.
He zapped on her for that.
I mean, I get it. You know what I mean? Like you're teaching, because you can't perceive somebody to be hateful that they're doing something wrong. They're just being hateful. You know, I got it. But yeah, again, I'm with you. I'll turn a blind eye to that shit. You know what I mean? But so, he's doing the right thing. You got to be. It's a teachable moment. As a parent, you got to teach him the right thing. You don't got to do the right thing as a parent. You got to say the right things. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So somehow we went from that scene to Empire with Hakeem rapping on the stage. Who are these whack-ass dudes rapping? And then all of a sudden, Lala walks up. There's only one dude
rapping in the DJ. Don't do that to him, yo. Don't do that DJ like that.
But I was praying the whole time that they was not about to make that no music scene. I was about to be salty as hell.
You know what? I always want this shit to be like New York Undercover. Like, I want a whole every week to have a special guest. Fucking do something in the goddamn club. Am I the only one that wants that?
Yes.
Yes, you are.
No, you're tripping. In episode 7, they was in the jazz club. We could have got a nice fucking star. Fucking do a little cameo. And then this episode, we could have got another little star doing a cameo in the fucking jazz club.
There's enough musicals going on. Don't nobody got time. Next thing you know, Mary J. Blige is going to be in there doing that same dance that she does.
Hey, and that's what I'm here for.
What do you got against Mary J.?
I love her. She just needs a new dance move.
Jeez. Hey, that's my favorite auntie. You know that. Don't you take my favorite auntie out of it. She be out here grooving, and she sing from her soul, and I feel that music.
If we had a 30-second
clip of her song, niggas would be like, yo, this shit is the best shit ever. Like,
No, they wouldn't.
So you act like New York Undercover wasn't a thing, yo. So we gonna act like those cameos in New York Undercover weren't good? We gonna act like the music song?
Danielle, I'm too young to remember that show.
Thank you. Don't be pushing my age. I don't have time.
Yeah, New York Undercover, change your life. Malik Yoba before, first of all, I've seen it.
Thank you. Stop coming for me.
Brandon tried to kick you. I didn't do that. I didn't come for you, sister.
No, I was defending her. I was not calling her old like you.
What I'm saying is, she's seen the show, so you was wrong.
Anyway.
In my gratitude log, I said I'm thankful for my amazing Black women in my life. Every day, Danielle. So, boom, there you go. I always big up you. Anyway.
Thanks so much.
Also, why was Lala talking like that? Like, he was talking mad, slow, and weird. Like, the fuck is wrong with you, boy?
I just brought me back, nigga. They brought me back on the seventh day I rose, nigga. On the seventh day I rose.
So
don't you tell me I can't talk slow.
So then you get another scene of Gambi being shady as fuck, and he in the middle of some parking lot in the dark. I'm like, who the fuck is he meeting with? They roll that window down. I see Hollis Doyle face. And I'm like, oh, God, they got a racist ass person here. Before he even said anything, he started going on about how they was in the ASA and how they knew their whole point was to come kill these metahumans. And, you know, we know you found out who Black Lightning is. You ain't tell us who this nigga is. So we about to come here and find him and kill him. And Gambi's like, why you got to do that? You know you don't got to do that. And then he starts saying all this racist shit. He was like, I hate being in Freeland. All the food is fried. I'm like.
I said disrespectful.
Jesus.
Hating on the fried food. He know he was tearing that fried chicken up. Talking about something they ain't good for nothing. I was just
Everybody
so
likes fried chicken. Don't try to act like it's just Black people.
So then he Hollis. Said, give them some green light so they can have a purpose. I wouldn't be like, no, he did not.
Mm-mm-mm. See, he had to make up because Tobias ain't say nothing racist in this episode. So they had to bring somebody else in to do the racist comments.
Very true.
So, I mean, I like how every time someone dies or a villain gets hurt, I like how they always bring out another asshole. I think it makes show.
You just gotta love it. You gotta love that. You know what I mean? We keep getting somebody to hate. I love it.
Got rid of this asshole. Hello, here's a new one. Thanks.
So then you see Jefferson and Lynn geeking and laughing and being cute as shit together. And they talking about maybe we need to test Jennifer for powers. I'm like, first of all, y'all should have been tested Anissa and Jennifer long time ago. You know that nigga got powers? Like, that shit can pass down. And what you don't think it got nothing to do with his DNA? You should have been tested them. So I'm like, this is late as shit. Y'all don't care about y'all kids.
You ain't watching that. It took forever. Now all of a sudden they had to find out when they turning up on people.
So then Jefferson, he kind of mad at Gambi a little bit, but he's still talking to him, and he like,
rightly so.
We're gonna find out. I gotta prove myself, my innocence, so I can go out there and save the community. So we're gonna go to the morgue and check out Lady Eve's body. And so this whole time he's using it as like a training exercise. And they get to this wall, and he's like, she about to fucking destroy the whole building. He's like, all right, you don't gotta use all your strength every time you hit somebody. Like, there's levels to this shit. So he was like, don't do that much. So she touched that bitch with one finger. I was like, all right, that's very, like, you being real, like, sarcastic right now. Like, you being real finicky. Like, you knew that wasn't going to break shit. Why you had to go to the extreme? So then she still overdid it and broke that wall down. And so they get in here, and I'm like, all right, Lady Eve probably not even here. And then they go to her, and she is, like, burnt to a crisp. I was like, how you even know that's her? Like, what the fuck?
That is true, because that bitch was like, she like a crispy-ass chicken nugget, yo. She was fucked up.
I said it had to be the titties. Like, they had to have her naked. And it's nobody who's got titties that big, so that was like, it had to be Lady Eve.
Burnt-up titties that big, no.
So then, like, this is a med student, so she was like, oh, this pattern don't fucking work. Meanwhile, Jefferson's going on this long rant about shit. And him and Gambi, and this and Gambi, like, look, Jefferson, I don't know what the fuck you talking about, but this is what we came here for, and these patterns ain't from you. It looked like somebody electrocuted him with some nuclear weapon. So it's like, Gambi, can you track these nukes? And he's like, of course. You know, I'm on the CW. I know the Arrow team and all that shit. I can track shit. So then, meanwhile, you cut to Lynn, and she fucking desperate, like, where are my samples? My samples are gone. And I was like, nobody got no backups. Like, y'all just test the shit and throw it away. That shit don't make no sense. And then they was like, oh, we got a paper backup somewhere here. Let me go check that out. And then they got it. And so
the only reason they had the paper backup, because somebody came in and stole their shit. And the only reason they had a paper backup was because that lady was out sick.
So then you cut to the school, and Jennifer's like, and so Lynn is all freaking out. So Jennifer's like, I'm about to be at the school late. She's like, all right, then. And she's like, oh, all right.
I just knew Jennifer was going on some freak turnout type shit, like, but.
But she was at the school hanging up posters, and I was like, why the fuck are all these people in the school? It's supposed to be late. It's just mad people just walking around the school late as shit.
Because Mr. Pierce. Fucking Mr. Clark saved fucking Freeland. He gave them kids a safe place to stay when they can't be out here on these streets. So that's why they in school late as fuck, doing good shit.
So then Jennifer's friend want to hang up a poster. She's like, I'm going to hang my poster higher than these other niggas' posters. Like, Jennifer's like, why are you going to do that? She's like, because if I'm higher, they ain't going to take it down. So she climbed up on this raggedy-ass, like, fixture. I'm like, oh, God, something bad about to fucking happen. And she almost fall, but then Jennifer triggers her powers got triggered. So Danielle, what'd you think about that? Jennifer getting powers?
That was good enough for me. Just that one little part of the show. I like how her friend was doing something stupid that she kept trying to tell her not to do. And I like how that was the way of her discovering her powers. Cause of course, you know, she's like, what the hell? How the hell did I get all this? Like, what the fuck's going on? I think it was dope as hell, though. Like, I always, now that she has them, I'm just curious as to how, you know, I definitely feel like it's going to make her and Anissa's relationship even stronger. So I think that's dope as fuck, because they'll be able to be more comfortable around each other, knowing that they both have something. So I'm just really excited, like, really excited.
Right, and then you got to realize that Jennifer was calling Anissa and fucking Jefferson out about fucking acting funny around her, because they've been talking about, they've been training and doing clear shit, and then Jefferson got mad at Anissa, and then they like, oh, what's going on? And Jennifer could tell. My only thing about Jennifer is, what the fuck are her powers? Like, I really don't know. Like, I'm Brandon, do you know her?
I don't think she knows yet. They're not going to do her powers from the comic book, so I'm interested to see how they do it. I think it's going to be probably some type of fire or sparking thing based on how she was fucking up her phone.
Yeah, that shit was done.
So then we get the weirdest fucking scene with fucking Lala in the shower. And Luanda's in the shower with him. And I'm like, this shit is fucking crazy. What the hell is going on? And then next thing you know, they start kissing.
Like kissing?
I'm like, what?
That was
like,
so disgusting. That was not even sexy.
No, it wasn't sexy. He killed her.
Yeah.
Like, fuck? No, but I'm just saying, though, like, if he was to kill a bad bitch, that would have been like, damn, that's sexy as hell. But she just looked like she looked hard as fuck, like a dude. So it just...
Damn. Stop shaming these black women. What are you...
She looked like a dude. She looked like a dude in that shower. She really did.
Her skin was fucking cocoa brown, and I love every second of it. But I was disturbed about all of that shit. Cause I'm like, yo, like, are you fucking kissing the ghost? Are they gonna show a sex scene with a ghost? Like, how does this happen?
He woke the fuck up, though, that shit was funny. Yeah, that shit was
crazy. I'm glad, though. I'm definitely glad he woke the fuck up, because I was just like, I don't want to see a sex scene with them. I just don't, because it's already disturbing. Because like Brandon said, he killed that bitch. Like,
so then we find out that Lynn gets Alvin Pierce's the shit, and it matches. Like the green light. And so somebody been working on this green light for 30 years. So this ain't Tobias shit at all. And then Anissa is in the woods with, they find that shit in the woods, and they went there and they went shit with Jefferson.
They found a lead to find the fucking, the trace of the nuclear power. And they end up finding the fucking gun.
Yeah, but before that, they cut the Gambi and he had church. And I'm like, yo, what is up with this dude? And he up there praying to God, like, can Jesus help me get through this? And I'm like, you probably...
Fuck him for life.
You're going to have to talk to somebody. So he's like, I got to talk to Jefferson. So Black Lightning and this are back in the woods. And he's like, oh, here go the weapons. He called Henderson up. Hey, Henderson, I'm at these coordinates. Because I guess Henderson know coordinates and shit. Like, that's not how you put shit in fucking GPS. But I guess cops got shit, because I don't know shit about no damn coordinates.
Yeah.
And then, you know, then you see this white dude roll up, and this is like, hey, I don't think he with the cops. And I'm like, yeah, I don't think he with the cops. And it's a Jefferson dumbass walk over there, and he about to die for Anissa to save his life. And because the nuclear weapons, the dude ain't no shit about it, and they fucking blew up. And I'm like, now Henderson gonna think you set his ass up. And he was about to get blown up to smithereens. And now you're going to be even more wanted. Like, you stupid idiot. The fuck?
My man came home and talked to Lynn. And was proud, like a proud pappy. She saved my life, Lynn. She can do this, Lynn. I'm excited. That's a baby.
Yeah, he was proud as shit.
and then he starts saying the wee shit. Boy. There was no more me shit. It was all about we. I was like, damn.
So then Lynn was like, look, you need to go talk to Gambi. He's like, what? He's like, just go talk to Gambi. Lynn's like, just go talk to him. So he rolls up there, and then Gambi comes creeping. He's like, all right, my name is something Esposito. I'm from this other town. I worked for the ASA, and I came here because we had this vaccine that inadvertently created metahumans. So I was tasked with other people to come here and get rid of all the metahumans. And he said, but when I got here, your dad had been doing research, and I'm the one that leaked the information to him about the vaccine that was going on, because I felt bad about what my people were doing to the people in your city, but that's what got him killed. And you were experimented on when you was a kid. That's how you got your powers. And he's like, look, I took it upon me to protect you this whole time, to make sure that the ASA don't come after you. But now them niggas is after you. They in the city right now trying to kill you, and I can't protect you anymore. And I'm like, golly, this dude is a fucking, he been through some shit, but I don't know. And then Jefferson's like, I'm angry at you, Gambi. We're done. Don't ever talk. Don't come to my family ever again. So
what, yeah, he mad.
So what'd you guys think about that?
I'm like,
please. I feel like he deserved it, finally. Oh, shiesty self.
You know, I know. Fucking for life, so I'm good.
He was doing too much, and he finally, Cat got his motherfucking tongue. I'm so glad that he put, like, I'm just glad that he made him feel like shit. Because you could tell Gammy was hurt. Like, he was hurt for real when he said that.
Gambi kept him alive. He'd have been dead if it wasn't for Gambi right now.
I mean, you're kind of right. But, I mean, at the same time, that nigga still play both sides, yo. That nigga still playing both sides. But he did keep Jefferson alive and raised him like he was his own son. So I guess that's his almost a redeeming quality, but fucking for life for playing both sides. It literally got Tobias out here doing shit for Tobias, too. You know what I mean? Like, I can't fuck with that shit, yo.
So but, then you go to Jennifer, because Jennifer a real one. She don't beat around the bush like Anissa and Jefferson. As soon as she finds out some shit, she's like, hey, girl, look, listen. Some weird shit happened to me earlier today. Like, I need to talk to you. And Anissa's like, I don't really got time for this shit. And she's like, look the fuck I did to my phone. And she was like, how'd you do that? And she's like, I got powers, bitch. What the fuck you mean? And so then I'm like, oh, look at this. This is going to be cool. But I think she's going to be mad. At when she find out that her daddy, Black Lightning, and then Anissa got powers too, and they ain't tell her, I think she gonna be mad. What y'all think gonna happen?
I don't know how the Jennifer the whole thing when they revealed Jennifer that she's Black Lightning and then Jennifer has these powers. I mean, Anissa has these powers. I don't know how Jennifer's gonna take that shit. Like, cause
you feel like cause they kept her out the loop, she's gonna be mad. No, I don't think so. I think she's going to be like, what the fuck? Because I think she's going to be understanding as to why they didn't say anything at first.
You think you're going to fucking blame for fucking, what's the boy name? God damn it.
Khalil.
Yeah, you think, I mean, you could prevent that shit?
I think that could play back in some type of
way. Fuck, I can't wait to see my man. I can't wait to see that nigga walk, yo. I can't wait to see that nigga come back. Woo! He going to be mad. Ooh! Ain't nothing like an angry nigga, yo. Ain't nothing like an angry nigga on TV.
Well, just wait, because when Jennifer got her powers now, then Khalil gonna come back. She gonna set his ass back.
Yeah, she gonna get that ass. She gonna get that ass.
He gonna have powers, too. All right, that's it for this episode. What are you guys looking forward to next week, Danielle?
I would like to see Khalil. I want to see what's gonna go on with him, the progress with him and everything. Being that... Tobias' sister is dead. I know his rage is about to be on 1,000.
Yes.
So I'm curious to see how he acts with that. And I really just don't like that racist dude that they showed in the beginning. What's his name that played in Scandal?
I don't know his Hollis name here, but I know his name.
I don't
Hollis.
Know what his name is, but I hope. I just want to see him get his ass kicked because he's talking too much shit.
That nigga got killers with him. That nigga got killers. He got killers with him. So, I mean, I don't know. I don't know if he's going to get anything anytime soon, but he got them killers with him.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking forward to, we need some more Latavius Lala intro music every time he on the screen. And I just want to see like what his real powers are. Because I just don't know. I just know he's bugging out and he's talking to fucking, what's that woman's name?
LaWanda.
I'm definitely trying to see Jennifer's power reveal to everybody else. And then how that goes. I don't think we're going to see her suit this year, but, you know, I'm always looking forward to that. And then we need some more stuff in Freeland High, whatever. Oh, Green Garfield, yeah. We need some more stuff like that because I need to see Karen. I ain't seen her in like 2 episodes, and I miss her. That's a beautiful Black woman that I would love to look at on TV. and then just more. I love Lynn. I just love Lynn and how she's doing her part from her expertise as far as being a neurosurgeon or whatever she is. And fuck Gambi for life. But and like Danielle said, I'm waiting to see fucking Tobias's fucking rage get taken out because he lost his sister. But yeah, just love this show. It's a Black event every fucking Tuesday. And I'm glad we get to do this shit, yo.
Yeah, I'm hoping we get double racism next episode with Hollis and Tobias being racist as fuck in the city. That'll be very entertaining. I want to see Jennifer trying to train to get her powers, but I don't think they're going to train her. They're going to try to be like, you too young for this and blah, 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 and she's going to get angry. So I'm ready for that, but hopefully Michelle might surprise me. And I want to get more background on what the fuck's going on with Lala, because that's just too weird for me right now.
Yeah, it's weird as fuck, yeah.
Yo, the white bitch got some lines, yo. Did the white bitch get some lines? The bitch that wrote was Tobias. What did she do? I forgot. She had a scene.
Oh, I don't remember. I didn't write that down.
Damn. Because Tobias' sister had said something to the white bitch. And I was like, oh, shit. She got a line or something. She got a name. What's her name?
I don't know her name.
The nigga said, Tobias' sister said her name, but Tobias called her over there, some shit like that. I was like, oh, shit. She got some shine. But, oh, well. That was just a random thought.
Also,
my fucking nigga that died, Huggy Bear, his son played football. And for the Raiders, that shit's still crazy to me.
Yes, his son played USC as well. All right. All right, guys. Thank you guys for listening to our episodes. We did two this time for Black Lightning. Make sure you check us out on iTunes, Stitcher, Google Play, anytime, anywhere you get your podcast. Leave us a 5-star review. We'll be back later this week for the next episode of Black Lightning, and we'll talk to you guys later. I pray my dick get big as the Eiffel Tower, so I can fuck the world for 72 hours. Goddamn, I feel amazing. Damn, I'm in the matrix. My mind is living on cloud nine, and this nine is never on vacation. Start up that Maserati and vroom, vroom, I'm racing. Popping pills in the lobby, and I pray they don't find her naked. And I pray you niggas is hating. Shooters go after Judas. Jesus Christ, if I live life on my knees, ain't no need to do this. Park it in front of looters. Next to that church is chicken. All you pussies is losers. All my niggas is...